My name is Amol Nergurkar, the CEO of Patient Prism, and I'm here with Kathy Limcolata from i3Ignite, and we're having some amazing conversations about growing DSOs. So this conversation is really about the third stage of a DSO's growth stage, where they've built, they have grown, but they're now they're here with a couple hundred locations,
right.
And they're trying to just polish the structure,
right?
But there's exponential challenges there. Growth is a big challenge.
Right.
Complexity is a big challenge.
Right.
Managing growth and making sure your entire footprint ties together.
Right.
So how do you really look at advising these guys?
Sure. So obviously, when you get to that size of an organization, it's pretty challenging. But I'll just give you a couple of thoughts, right? So again, and we've mentioned this in some of the other stages, is that you really want to be understanding how different locations are performing relative to their peer group. Okay, so when you get to this size of a business, you've probably created some clusters, right, of businesses that you feel are in either like markets, like size, whatever it is. But you're starting to really help them do what you did earlier,
right,
in terms of figuring out where they are and what they need to do to get to the top end of their peer group. But you're doing it in a way that it makes sense, right? Because
right.
if you do it across 300 locations or whatever, the average makes no sense, right?
Right.
So you're really trying to kind of fine-tune and tailor and then have some diagnostic tools. So you can start to anticipate when a location's starting to go off the rails. Because
right.
you probably have some field teams in place, other ones who can start to address that, but you've got to know it's coming. And so you've got to have a way to deal with that. And then another thing that I would be looking at is for the DSO itself, are there some additional things they can do in the centralized services that would make a significant difference, right? So this is where you're starting to address primarily the cost side of things.
Sure.
But there could be other areas where you're, and this is something that we feel very strongly about, that you're continuing to iterate in areas where you think will improve the business, right?
Sure.
So you've got a process, you've got teams that are actually working on things, trying them, seeing what the impact is, and then deciding which one should move forward and which one aren't. So you've got a process of continuing improvement that continues to move the whole organization forward, and that's really, really important. And then the other thing that I would typically look at would be around new revenue streams, right? So as you look at the range of different businesses you're in or whatever business models, are there some new services? Are there new products? Are there things that would start to incrementally grow the revenue of these locations that could be applied in lots of different places? So there's ways to continue to add new things to
right.
the overall plot that will continue to drive revenue. But it just becomes harder because you have to do more kind of segmentation, you've got to do more targeting, you've got to do a lot more kind of deep dive work in
right.
the areas where you think it's going to make a difference.
And you, at this point, you definitely need people that are in charge of those different areas, right? That's
oh,
why
absolutely.
You have all these
growth
chief revenue officers,
right.
chief marketing officer, because you want them to kind of laser focus.
That's right.
You don't want them wearing many hats.
No, you don't.
At that
and
stage.
You want that team to be working as a team around the things that are going to be most impactful. So that's the other thing which I think we tend to do a lot with is just make sure that whole group is spending its time collectively in the areas that are going to really make a difference against their target. Because there are a lot of things that an individual group might be doing,
right.
but if it's not going to move the whole business forward, then maybe they should be moving some of their energy in a different direction.
But how do you cascade the goals of an organization from the CEO level to the front office at one of your locations when you're that big?
Right. Well, I think that, again, for me, a little bit is back to the model, right?
Okay.
So for whatever my business model is, I've got a target in terms of what I'm trying to do with that location. You can start with that. And then everyone at that location knows exactly what it is and what their role is in delivering that,
sure,
right?
Sure.
And then you've got maybe some kind of a, you know, either regions or again, peer groups. It rolls up, but you've kind of started down here
right.
and build it up. And then where it gets tricky, I think, is where you've decided that as a business you want to grow some number and you
right.
start to cascade things back down.
Right.
That tends to be very, very difficult to implement. And in a location-based model, it's not always very successful. But so you kind of go back and forth between kind of really looking ground up in terms
right.
of what's possible
right.
and then continuing to drive things kind of top down that could work, maybe not mandating in every location, but
right.
trying to engage that location and adding one more thing or one more service area. And then over time, that starts to really get some traction.
But driven by some data, though.
I mean, absolutely.
Because that's where you get consistency and then people
right.
buy in
that's
because
right.
they believe the data.
Well, we do a lot of piloting, right? So
okay.
as you get into some of these things that, you know, maybe either hard for people to get behind or they're just not sure whether it's going to work.
Right.
You do a lot of experimentation. You prove it with data. You can show the difference. And then you then have the basis to really take that out and have them embrace it because they know it works, right? It's not like I think this,
right.
I know this, right?
Right, because we've tried and piloted this. Yeah, and sometimes we've failed, but for the you've gotten to a point where you've succeeded.
Yeah. And, if we failed, we know we failed, right?
Right.
And we probably tried something else because we still like the idea, maybe, but we're going to try to do it in this way.
Correct.
And then we're going to see if it's better or not, or we may try something else, right? So we continue to go down that iteration path
right.
to make sure that what we're bringing to the organization really makes sense.
This is fascinating. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.